Hello and welcome to my new tutorial. This is gonna take a lot of time. Oh my god, I have something. I'm cooking something up right now. Like this is probably the hardest part of the tutorial already, but I am gonna make a tutorial about everything in UHC basically. Like every upgrade. Well, like apart from all the vanilla mechanics. Excuse me, I'm kinda sick. Apart from all the vanilla mechanics that you've got like your whole shop of amazing crafting recipes and stuff. So, starting off with a bang, we are gonna show and try to explain every extra ultimate that there is in UHC on Hypixel. And after that, you'll see every single profession on my channel as well. I'll make a playlist for you. So you'll see like how it'll all go and stuff. But yes, let's go in a circle like this. Where do we want to start? Let's start off here, I guess. Sure. All right. Hide if Leviathan. Well, I could show it in action, but it's really all there is to it is just it's prop 4, and prop 4 means you have a high reduction of damage, which, it helps against any damage that isn't true damage. True damage, what true damage is damage that goes through armor and stuff that basically it's just dependent on what your original health is. Like, for example, the Axe of Brune does, I think, a total of 4 hearts of true damage. We'll come back to that later though, but true damage is basically does not get affected by this or by any other like protection levels or armor pieces. But yeah, for any non-true damage, so anything like a dragon sword or sharpness or anything, like just a powerful sword will definitely get stopped for the most part by these. Because they're prot 4 and prot 4 is really strong. I'm not really sure how protection values compare to armor points, but I think that 1 armor point is about the equivalent of 1.5 protection levels or so. And actually, protection 4, I might be able to show you that. Protection 4 has an EPF value of 5, and EPF, I'm not really sure what it stands for, but basically. So protection 1 has an EPF value of 1. That's like how much protection it would give you. So then prot 2 will give you 2 EPF and so forth. But prot 4, for some reason, gives you 5 EPF. Yeah, 5 EPF, which, yeah, is really cool. Because that means it's even stronger than what you would expect. So basically having what you would expect is a prot 4 piece has the same amount of protection as if you have prot 2 on your helmet and prot 2 on your boots, right? But actually, you could have prot 3 on your boots and prot 2 on your helmet, and then it's the equivalent of prot 4. So prot 4 is extraordinarily strong. I assume you got that by now. This is pretty useful. It costs 2 extra diamonds though. If you are a looter like me, then you'll get slime balls, and with slime balls you can make dragon armor. But we'll come back to that. So if you're not a looter, then this is definitely your upgrade. On to the Exodus. Exodus has I'm not really sure how many seconds. Sorry, I don't have this one all locked. But it gives you regen upon hit. And hit will mean like anything with your sword or your fist or any other melee type of damage. So not bow shots, not snowballs, not anything. I think that used to be a bug where it did do that. But yeah, it costs this, as you can see. Player head, not that expensive, just 5 diamonds. I guess the emeralds are somewhat hard to get, but not that much. So Exodus is pretty expensive. It costs 350,000. The hide costs 150,000. So I guess that's a little bit less expensive for you if you want that. But you still need all the professions and stuff maxed out like I do. If you want to upgrade most of them, well, this one costs or needs Bloodcraft. This one needs Bloodcraft. Like, a lot of them need Bloodcraft. If you want to get extra ultimates, you'll definitely have to max out Bloodcraft and some other stuff. Make sure you don't save for an extra ultimate and then figure out that you don't have the required professions. But yeah, moving on. Exos gives you regen upon hit. Not sure how many seconds, but yeah, you'll regenerate some health whenever you hit a player. Hit and run would be a good strategy with Exodus, and you definitely want to do that. Okay, Flask of Ichor. Again, this comes down to true damage. It's an instant damage potion of level 3, I think. Level 1 would do 2 hearts, I think. Level 2 would do 4 hearts, and then level 3 would do 8 hearts because it's amplifying, basically, 2 to the power of X. Which means that, instant damage 4 would deal 16 hearts. This works the same with instant health effects, by the way. But yeah, so 8 hearts of true damage if you aim this right. If you miss your target, on the other hand, it'll do a slightly less big amount of damage. But yeah, that's a pretty strong potion. Not that expensive to craft either. Still costs a head though. But Ichor costs 120k to unlock. Artemis Bow, 25% chance to lock onto your enemy. I don't think it says that here, but your arrows, 1 in 4 arrows that you shoot, if they get in, I believe, a 10 block radius of your enemy, they will start homing towards them. Homing, as you can imagine, well, it actually just kind of curves and then it goes straight to your target. But if there's a wall in between, it'll still not hit, so be aware. If you're taking down sky bases, it's not like it will automatically hit. Like, it won't go, like, say, your target is behind this wall, you shoot, and it'll go right through the wall. If you shoot this way, however, it'll lock on, and it'll go, like, from here to there, sort of, if that makes sense. But yeah, it's not too expensive to craft. I suppose the enderpearl for the ender eye is pretty hard to get. But it's 100,000 to unlock. And yeah, that's the Artemis bow. Daredevil, horse with maximum speed, I think. It is incredibly fast. It has like 20 or 24 hearts. James, what are you doing here? Brother, I'm trying to record. Okay, whatever. So, Daredevil. Daredevil is a horse with maximum speed, 24 hearts of health, which is pretty dang cool. It costs in the shop a total of 150,000. James is being a bully right now. You should have the recipe memorized, but you can always look it up. Okay, so that's a horse with maximum speed. It costs a head and a saddle. And I think it already has a saddle when you spawn it as well. Or maybe it doesn't. I'm not actually sure because I don't know if it unlocked. But anyways, the King's Rod. Compass. You can literally just get a bucket and then you can craft it. And 2 string and 2 lily pads, but not that hard. Luck of the Sea 4. Or no, wait. Yeah. Luck of the Sea 4, Lure 3, Unbreaking X. Unbreaking X, I guess, is good for combat as well. If you want like a fishing rod that lasts forever, that's definitely your bet. Yeah, it does cost a compass, so if you're crafting it early game, like I did several times, you will not be able to track your teammates for until you get a kill, which might get slightly on your nerves. Or you could just craft an actual compass, but you can actually use your teammate tracker for it too. So it's pretty easy. This is kind of bugged. I'm not sure if it's intended or not by Minecraft, but for some reason, Luck of the Sea 4 and Lure 3 on the same rod makes the Luck of the Sea 4 not actually work, because Luck of the Sea 4, as you would expect it actually acts like Luck of the Sea 1, I'm pretty sure. Which is, it means that it's not going to be as efficient, but it's still, like, way faster than a normal fishing rod. So And it only costs shit, am I lagging? No, I'm not. King's Rod costs 50,000 coins. I don't know if you find that expensive. I don't anyway. Dice of God is 100,000. Yes, got it right. This is Mossy Cobblestone. Mossy Cobble is from spawners or Mega Taiga or a Jungle Temple. This is a jukebox, not a note block, so you need one diamond and a player head for it. So yeah, that is just to get a diamond and some Mossy Cobble and then get a kill, and then you get the Dice of God. I didn't actually tell you what the Dice of God does. It will give you a random one of these extra ultimates that I'm showing here. So you can get beautiful ender chests, or XP bottles, or golden carrots. Or actually, I never got this from the Pandora, the Pandora, Dice of God, or this. But yeah, you can get any of these from the dice, which is really cool because, you know, dice OP. You can get like an axe. Okay, I should just imagine one of the few things that I'm telling you right now. And yeah, you can get that. So just figure out your chances on your own. Deus Ex Machina. This is, I don't know if I pronounced that right. Res like 5, resistance 5. Resistance, I'm guessing you know damage resistance, so you'll take way less damage. Again, this does not go up for true damage. So if someone has an Axe of Brynn, you're still fucked if you're drinking this at one heart. But any, you know, normal weapon will not hurt you if you have resistance on at all, because resistance 5, I'm pretty sure, is infinite damage resistance. Like, it will literally not touch your hearts at all if anyone hits you within those 10 seconds. And you can turn this into a splash potion if you put it in a brewing stand with gunpowder as well, which means even more OP. Okay, Void Box is pretty useless. I don't actually unlock it because I find it very useless. But player head, glass gives you two ender chests. Ender chests can be used to store items and then pick them up somewhere else if you want to have extra storage space. But you rather just kind of break them to get the obsidian and then build a portal without having to like use buckets and stuff. But yeah, you can use it to build a portal. This is pretty useful if you go into the Nether, and if you find like a fortress really far away from your own portal, then you could per se like buy, or not buy, sorry, build another portal wherever you want to. And then go back into the overworld that way. Might link up with somebody else's portal though, then you're also fucked. XP bottles, leaves, not that hard to get. Glowstone, somewhat hard to get. That's just, you know. And then a redstone block, and then a bottle, and then an enchantment table. And that will give you 32 XP bottles. Also, pretty useless in my opinion. All of these, last three are pretty dang cheap. Oh, this one actually isn't, but these other two, and this one is really cheap to buy. This one gives you, I think it's kind of bugged because if you eat one and then eat another one, it won't actually give you the effect again. So keep that in mind, but this will give you two hearts of absorption and infinite saturation. So saturation will say that you won't ever lose hunger for 10 minutes. So 10 minutes of absorption two, or absorption one, so two hearts of absorption is really strong in my opinion. And yeah, you'll have a crap ton of those. You'll have five if you use one gapple, and one gapple would heal you four hearts and two absorption hearts. That is six total hearts. Well, this gives you 10 total hearts, so it is pretty worth it. Also, the absorption lasts longer than a normal gapple does. Yeah, in my opinion, it's pretty okay. Okay, Chest of Fate. It will If it has a 50-50 chance, either it blows up, leaves a crater, and deals half of your health, again, true damage. So half of your health, no, wait, not half of your health, a total of 10 hearts to you. So if you are below 10 health, 10 hearts and graft, oh my god, craft the chest of fate, and then it blows up, then you will die. So rip. But the other 50%, you can get an absorption 4 potion, which gives you a total of 10 absorption hearts. And I think it lasts 1 minute or 2 minutes. Either, I'm not really sure. And that absorption, you can actually. There's another bug. I don't know if I'm supposed to spoil this, but I mean, I think it's just implemented in Minecraft that way. But absorption 4, if you eat a gapple, or probably one of these as well. If you eat a gapple after you drank an absorb 4, it will, no matter what, refill all of those absorption hearts, even if, you know, they're not depleted yet, or if they are completely depleted. So basically, you have 10 hearts of absorption, you lose them, and then you eat another gapple, and you have the whole full 10 hearts of absorption again, which is, in some people's eyes, pretty overpowered. So Chest of Fate is probably worth it. Maybe that's why I bought it. Death Scythe, two heads, two bones, not hard to get. Clock, you'll have to look up the recipe for that one, I forgot. But it deals 20% of your enemy's total health as in, he's on 40, it will deal, okay, 20% of 40, not really sure. But basically 20% of anything his health is will be depleted. So if he's on one heart, he will be on one heart after that hit, probably. Plus another attack damage that your fist would do. Again, not that effective. But yeah, 20%, that's pretty overpowered. It has a limited amount of uses. I believe it's only like 10 or 13 or anywhere between that. I have not prepared for this, I'm sorry. But yeah, 20% of their total health that they have at that moment. So worth it if they are on full and if they have a lot of armor or such, again, true damage. So, you know, abuse that whenever you can. Moving on, Andril, Blaze Rod, important part of this. 18 iron, feathers, not really important. Sharpness 1 on the sword, can't combine it with anything. No enchantments on it. Sharpness 1, res 1 effect, potion effect, yes. And a speed 1 effect as well. It will only trigger if you hold the sword in your hand. And rip. Okay, the Excalibur, I actually have a video of this. I'll show you what it does in action. Just remember this crafting recipe. The pufferfish is important. The TNT is pretty hard to get. You need a desert temple if you want to make that. Obsidian, keep that in mind. And a diamond sword. A clip will be on screen now. Axe of Brune is two diamonds, a piece of TNT, so this can actually pretty is pretty doable. Five gunpowder plus another gunpowder for the fire charge and a blaze powder for that as well. It's pretty cheap, I guess. These both cost 150,000, by the way. As for the Andril, these are all 150,000. Yeah, the two diamonds, you gotta remember. Axe does almost the same as the Excalibur. I guess I'll show you a clip of that too. Axe has less true damage in it though, so remember that. I believe. I'm not really sure actually. Tablets of Destiny will give you sharpness 3, keep attention. Sharpness 3, fire aspect 2, power 3, and punch 1 all on one book. So you have to choose between a bow or a sword on which you want to put it. Magma cream, probably only for looters because they need a slime ball and a blaze powder. Golden sword, not that hard to get. Book and quill, just look it up on the Minecraft wiki. XP bottles from like a Pandora's or from the recipe from like engineering, I think. Not really sure actually. Probably from enchanting. Yeah, enchanting, that's it. And then a bow. And then you have your tablets, and then you can make yourself an OP item. Those cost 250,000. Okay, well, I guess that does it for this video. I'm gonna tune out now, but there's gonna be more of these tutorials. Tell me if you enjoyed, because that helps me be motivated to make all of these for you, because I will do every profession if this goes right. And yeah, you will just be a complete UHC god after watching all of those videos. Might take you some time, but it'll be worth it, trust me. And I'm not just saying that because I want a lot of views. Anyway, peace out. See you in the next one. What you would expect is a prop four piece has the same amount of protection as if you have prot two on your helmet and prot two on your boots, right? But actually, you could have prot three on your boots and prot two on your helmet, and then it's the equivalent of prot four. So prot four is extraordinarily strong. I assume you got that by now. This is pretty useful. It costs two extra diamonds though. If you are a looter like me, then you'll get slime balls, and with slime balls you can make dragon armor. But you know, we'll come back to that. So if you're not a looter, then this is definitely your upgrade. On to the Exodus. Exodus has I'm not really sure how many seconds. Sorry, I don't have this one unlocked. But it gives you regen upon hit. And hit will mean like anything with your sword or your fist or any other melee type of damage. So not bow shots, not snowballs, not anything. I think that used to be a bug where it did do that. But yeah, it costs this, as you can see. Player head, not that expensive, just five diamonds. I guess the emeralds are somewhat hard to get, but not that much. So Exodus is pretty expensive. It costs 350,000. The hide costs 150,000. So I guess that's a little bit less expensive for you if you want that. But you know, you still need all the professions and stuff maxed out like I do. If you want to upgrade most of them. Well, this one costs or needs Bloodcraft. This one needs Bloodcraft. Like a lot of them need Bloodcraft. If you want to get extra ultimates, you'll definitely have to max out Bloodcraft and some other stuff. Make sure you don't save for an extra ultimate and then figure out that you don't have the required professions. But yeah, moving on. Exodus gives you regen upon hit. Not sure how many seconds, but yeah, you'll regenerate some health whenever you hit a player. Hit and run would be a good strategy with Exodus, and you definitely want to do that. Okay, Flask of Ichor. Again, this comes down to true damage. It's an instant damage potion of level 3, I think. Level 1 would do 2 hearts, I think. Level 2 would do 4 hearts. And then level 3 would do 8 hearts because it's amplifying, basically, 2 to the power of X. Which means that, you know, instant damage 4 would deal 16 hearts. This works the same with instant health effects, by the way. But yeah, so 8 hearts of true damage if you aim this right. If you miss your target, on the other hand, it'll do a slightly less big amount of damage. But yeah, that's a pretty strong potion. Not that expensive to craft either. Still costs a head though. But Ichor costs 120k to unlock. Artemis Bow, 25% chance to lock onto your enemy. I don't think it says that here, but your arrows, 1 in 4 arrows that you shoot, if they get in, I believe, a 10 block radius of your enemy, they will start homing towards them. Homing, as you can imagine, well, it actually just kind of curves and then it goes straight to your target. Hello and welcome to my new tutorial. This is gonna take a lot of time. Oh my god, I have something. I'm cooking something up right now. Like, this is probably the hardest part of the tutorial already, but I am gonna make a tutorial about everything in UHC, basically. Like, every upgrade. Well, like, apart from all the vanilla mechanics. Excuse me, I'm kind of sick. Apart from all the vanilla mechanics that you've got like your whole shop of amazing crafting recipes and stuff. So, starting off with a bang, we are gonna show and try to explain every extra ultimate that there is in UHC on Hypixel. And after that, you'll see every single profession on my channel as well. I'll make a playlist for you so you'll see like how it'll all go and stuff. But yes, let's go in a circle like this. Where do we want to start? Let's start off here, I guess. Sure. All right. Hide if Leviathan. Well, I could show it in action, but it's really all there is to it is just it's prot 4, and prot 4 means you have a high reduction of damage, which, it helps against any damage that isn't true damage. True damage, what true damage is damage that goes through armor and stuff that basically it's just dependent on what your original health is. Like, for example, the Axe of Brune does, I think, a total of 4 hearts of true damage. We'll come back to that later, though. But true damage is basically does not get affected by this or by any other, like, protection levels or armor pieces. But yeah, for any non-true damage, so anything like a dragon sword or sharpness or anything, like just a powerful sword will definitely get stopped for the most part by these. Because they're prot 4, and prot 4 is really strong. I'm not really sure how protection values compare to armor points, but I think that 1 armor point is about the equivalent of 1.5 protection levels or so. And actually, protection 4, I might be able to show you that. Protection 4 has an EPF value of 5, and EPF, I'm not really sure what it stands for, but basically, so protection 1 has an EPF value of 1, that's like how much protection it would give you. So then, Prot 2 will give you 2 EPF and so forth, but Prot 4 for some reason gives you 5 EPF. Yeah, 5 EPF, which, yeah, is really cool because that means it's even stronger than what you would expect. So basically having so keep that in mind, but this will give you 2 hearts of absorption and infinite saturation. So saturation will say that you won't ever lose hunger for 10 minutes. So 10 minutes of absorption 2 or absorption 1, so 2 hearts of absorption is really strong in my opinion. And yeah, you'll have a crap ton of those. You'll have 5 if you use 1 gapple, and 1 gapple would heal you 4 hearts and 2 absorption hearts. That is 6 total hearts. Well, this gives you 10 total hearts, so it is pretty worth it. Also, the absorption lasts longer than a normal gapple does. Yeah, in my opinion, it's pretty okay. Okay, Chest of Fate. It will. It has a 50-50 chance. Either it blows up, leaves a crater, and deals half of your health. Again, true damage. So, half of your health. No, wait, not half of your health. A total of 10 hearts to you. So, if you are below 10 health, 10 hearts and craft. Oh my god. Craft the Chest of Fate, and then it blows up. Then you will die. So, rip. But the other 50%, you can get an absorption 4 potion, which gives you a total of 10 absorption hearts. And I think it lasts 1 minute or 2 minutes. Either, I'm not really sure. And that absorption, you can actually. There's another bug. I don't know if I'm supposed to spoil this, but I mean, I think it's just implemented in Minecraft that way. But absorption 4, if you eat a gapple, or probably one of these as well. If you eat a gapple after you drank an absorb 4, it will no matter what refill all of those absorption hearts, even if, they're not depleted yet, or if they are completely depleted. So basically, you have 10 hearts of absorption, you lose them, and then you eat another gapple, and you have the whole full 10 hearts of absorption again, which is, in some people's eyes, pretty overpowered. So Chest of Fate is probably worth it. Maybe that's why I bought it. Death Scythe, two heads, two bones, not hard to get. Clock, you'll have to look up the recipe for that one, I forgot. But it deals 20% of your enemy's total health. Total health, as in, he's on 40, it will deal. 20% of 40, not really sure. But basically, 20% of anything his health is will be depleted. So if he's on one heart, he will be on one heart after that hit, probably. Plus another attack damage that your fist would do. Again, not that effective. But yeah, 20%, that's pretty overpowered. It has a limited amount of uses. I believe it's only like 10 or 13 or anywhere between that. I have not prepared for this, I'm sorry. But yeah, 20% of their total health that they have at that moment. So worth it if they are on full and if they have a lot of armor or such. Again, true damage. So, if there's a wall in between, it'll still not hit. So be aware. If you're taking down sky bases, it's not like it will automatically hit. Like, it won't go, like, say, your target is behind this wall, you shoot, and it'll go right through the wall. If you shoot this way, however, it'll lock on, and it'll go, like, from here to there, sort of, if that makes sense. But yeah, it's not too expensive to craft. I suppose the Ender Pearl for the Ender Eye is pretty hard to get. But it's 100,000 to unlock. And yeah, that's the Artemis bow. Daredevil, horse with the maximum speed, I think. It is incredibly fast. It has like 20 or 24 hearts. James, what are you doing here? Brother, I'm trying to record. Okay, whatever. So, Daredevil. Daredevil is a horse with maximum speed, 24 hearts of health, which is pretty dang cool. It costs in the shop a total of 150,000. James is being a bully right now. You should have the recipe memorized, but you can always look it up. Okay, so that's a horse with maximum speed. It costs a head and a saddle. And I think it already has a saddle when you spawn it as well. Or maybe it doesn't. I'm not actually sure because I don't know if it unlocked. But, anyways, the King's Rod. Compass. You can literally just get a bucket and then you can craft it. And two string and two lily pads, but not that hard. Luck of the Sea 4. Or, no, wait. Yeah. Luck of the Sea 4, Lure 3, Unbreaking X. Unbreaking X, I guess, is good for combat as well. If you want like a fishing rod that lasts forever, that's definitely your bet. Yeah, it does cost a compass, so if you're crafting it early game, like I did several times, you will not be able to track your teammates for until you get a kill, which might get slightly on your nerves. Or you could just craft an actual compass, but you can actually use your teammate tracker for it too. So it's pretty easy. This is kind of bugged. I'm not sure if it's intended or not by Minecraft, but for some reason, Luck of the Sea 4 and Lure 3 on the same rod makes the Luck of the Sea 4 not actually work as Luck of the Sea 4 as you would expect it. It actually acts like Luck of the Sea 1, I'm pretty sure. Which is, it means that it's not going to be as efficient, but it's still, like, way faster than a normal fishing rod. So. And it only costs. Shit, am I lagging? No, I'm not. King's Rod costs 50,000 coins. I don't know if you find that expensive. I don't, anyway. Dice of God is 100,000. Yes, got it right. This is Mossy Cobblestone. Mossy Cobble is from spawners or mega taiga or a jungle temple. This is a jukebox, not a note block, so you need one diamond and a player head for it. So yeah, that is just to get a diamond and some mossy gobble and then get a kill, and then you get the Dice of God. I didn't actually tell you what the Dice of God does. It will give you a random one of these extra ultimates that I'm showing here. So you can get beautiful ender chests, or XP bottles, or golden carrots. Or actually, I never got this from the Pandora, or the Pandora, Dice of God, or this, but yeah, you can get any of these from the dice, which is really cool because, you know, dice OP. You can get like an axe. Okay, I should just imagine one of the few things that I'm telling you right now. And yeah, you can get that. So just figure out your chances on your own. Deus Ex Machina. This is, I don't know if I pronounced that right. Res like 5, resistance 5. Resistance, I'm guessing you know, damage resistance, so you'll take way less damage. Again, this does not go up for true damage. So if someone has an Axe of Brynn, you're still fucked if you're drinking this at one heart. But any, you know, normal weapon will not hurt you if you have resistance on at all, because resistance 5, I'm pretty sure, is infinite damage resistance. Like, it will literally not touch your hearts at all if anyone hits you within those 10 seconds. And you can turn this into a splash potion if you put it in a brewing stand with gunpowder as well, which means even more OP. Okay, Void Box is pretty useless. I don't actually unlock it because I find it very useless. But player head, glass gives you two ender chests. Ender chests can be used to store items and then pick them up somewhere else if you want to have extra storage space. But you rather just kind of break them to get the obsidian and then build a portal without having to like use buckets and stuff. But yeah, you can use it to build a portal. This is pretty useful if you go into the Nether, and if you find like a fortress really far away from your own portal, then you could per se like buy, or not buy, sorry, build another portal wherever you want to, and then go back into the overworld that way. Might link up with somebody else's portal though, then you're also fucked. XP bottles, leaves, not that hard to get. Glowstone, somewhat hard to get. That's just, you know. And then a redstone block, and then a bottle, and then an enchantment table. And that will give you 32 XP bottles. Also, pretty useless in my opinion. All of these last three are pretty dang cheap. Oh, this one actually isn't, but these other two, and this one is really cheap to buy. This one gives you, I think it's kind of bugged because if you eat one and then eat another one, it won't actually give you the effect again.